Welcome to Plants vs. Zombies, I'm your host Lostwolfe, and this is episode 8. In the last episode, we got our friend a cherry bomb, or the jalapeno. I should say the cherry bomb is up there. And we're busy with the pool levels, so we're going to continue on in that vein. I think we're going to go collect that. These guys are the scary guys. On this level, these guys are the ones you want to watch out for. The rest are all kind of standard, and we've seen a lot of this before. I'm gonna go with, let's see, actually we'll go with some of these guys, Tangle Kelp, with this. I'm gonna need the Jalapeno, so I think what I'm gonna do, we'll take, so difficult, what do I pick? I think we'll go with this. And this, this and then this. Yeah, that looks good. Let's rock. So for the early part of this level, I'm probably going to be planting a lot of panic buttons. I didn't take enough panic buttons though, which is pretty bad, all things considered. I hope everyone's doing okay. I've been having a pretty restful couple of days. Where in fact I was terrible and didn't record World of Warcraft. The reason why I didn't record World of Warcraft wasn't because I didn't want to. Most of it just boiled down to I didn't know what to do, and I still am not entirely sure of what to do with that. I have a plan, and I'm probably going to try the plan and see if it works. So that should be sorted out soon. We'll see. Hopefully you won't be deprived. If you're watching World of Warcraft, I'm sorry. But hopefully before the end of the week, I will have sorted something out for you guys. Okay. This guy we can plant over here. And I can get going again with planting sunflowers. My plan is basically just to stall for a while until I can make myself a three-peater. I'll probably want to do that sooner rather than later. Actually, we're getting there. Three-peater. There we go. Awesome. Okay. I'm a little bit happier about life in general. Let's make you. And I can't. Well, okay, I'll tell you what we'll do. Ooh, problem. Yeah, that is a bit of a problem, actually. We'll do that and solve it for the time being. Oh, that guy died before he could get there. That's kind of productive. And cute. Okay. Let's go and grab one of you. Boom. Bye-bye. We barely knew ye. Okay, so now, what I really want to do is cover this set of rows as well. And that's perfect, because we got, basically pea shooters in all six rows. Okay. Which is great, because now it means I can do this and start planting again. Sunflowers. Hooray. I hate having to do this, but in a little while I'm going to have to take this guy out, so otherwise I'm just not going to be producing enough sun, and I'm going to have to plant a sunflower there, which is going to make me awfully sad. Well, oh hey, look at this. I think we'll deal with you by doing this. I don't think that I'm going to be able to shoot as many peas as I need to kill that guy, so it behooves me to be a little bit safe, and I'm just going to do that, because that's the best plan. Oh, wait, we may have a developing problem there, actually. Yeah. There. That may not work, incidentally. Yeah, I have a feeling it ain't gonna work here. Eat the plant. Very good. Haha. Fooled you. Okay. In large ways with zombies is approaching. Actually, you know what we should do? We should cover that row. Because these rows are gonna be pretty okay. I don't think they're gonna put, and they didn't, and I got very lucky, they didn't put any honed zombies on those rows. Oh boy, problem. This guy leaves a track of ice behind him, and he throws stuff, and ice makes it a little bit faster for the zombies to come across. So you want to get him dead as soon as you possibly can. Also, the faster you use your refresh on the jalapeno, the faster the recharge occurs. So if you just keep on using it, it will keep on recharging. I'm going to get rid of that guy, because we need this last sunflower. And there. Now we're okay. We're A-O good. Oh, Dave. What am I going to do without you? And now all that remains is basically to start planting sunflowers. I mean, sunflowers. What am I talking about? Three peaches here. Added firepower and another one in a second we'll get there. Just need to collect enough sun. And another one down there. And now we're good. Any extra firepower we add now is just over the top and will help a lot, but isn't necessary. I am probably going to add two more though. One on this row. And then another one. Bye. Oh, you dropped a coin. That's very good. One here. There we go. And that was the right choice instantly, because I didn't notice it, but there was a cone ant zombie on that row. Oh, there we go. Ooh. Okay, this is spikeweed. It pops tires and hurts zombies that step on it. Right. I don't know if you were noticing, but in the lower left-hand corner at the end of the level, it turned out that we have 5,000. There we go. So we can start buying things. I'm going to buy the 8th slot just to make my life easier. There we go. 8 slots. Great. Now you can see, like I said, they go up like crazy. This is 20,000. And my guess is, I've never actually bought the last one, but my guess is it's going to be 50,000 or something stupid like that. But that cleaned me out, so we're going to go back in. And now we have an extra slot. Normally what I like doing in the extra slot is I'll put a panic button in. So, again, we'll just go I want to show you the spikeweed. Although, I don't actually play with the spikeweed. I think it's kind of lame. But we're going to do it for this particular episode. Spikeweed feels to me like it's not doing enough damage. And it keeps on breaking and you have to replace it. So for me, it's a cost-benefit thing, and the costs of having spikeweed kind of outweigh the benefits. I do know that they're good against these guys, though, so some zombonies. So what we're going to do is that, we'll add another couple of panic buttons. We'll make this the panic button plan. And then 100. And we will go with... We'll go with this. Nah. Let's just go with this. Because I see bucketheads in the list. And more firepower is always good. Oh, you know what I'm doing? I'm being dumb. Hold on. Hold the phone. Yeah, I need this because the Zomboni's gonna kill me if I don't have it. So, lots of cheap plants? Okay, we'll go. Yeah, we'll do this. We'll do this. This, this, and this. There. Oh, I forgot the spike. Oh, I forgot the spike weed. Hold on. Hold on. Restart. Sorry, I forgot the spike weed. That was silly. Especially since this level is all about me showing you the spike weed. That was a little dumb on my behalf. I'm so sorry about that. We'll go back and do this. 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 Yeah, we'll do this, 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 and this. This is going to be terrifying without walnut. And, actually, come to think of it, yeah, I don't really like that plan too much. We'll do this, this. Even though, and this is the funny thing, okay, even though we have 9 slots, it's still a bit of an issue deciding what to put in. There we go. That's better. And I forgot the spike weed again. Oh, damn it. Oh well. What I'll do is I'll make a concession and take the spike weed next time, and you can see it. Oh. I'm sorry. That was silly. Okay, where are you coming from? There. Oh, that's a bit scary, actually. We may not have time to throw any of this stuff up. Not that the rate these guys are showing up, anyway. But that's why we've got a whole bunch of panic buttons now. So that we can actually put them down. Oh, that was a mistake. I am sorry, because that was silly. Let's kill that. I was aiming for the sunflower, and instead picked up the bomb. Like an idiot. Oh well. Yeah. There. You want to plant those as far back as you can, so you can delay kind of having to worry about the next zombie. And alas, for a change, I can't actually plant down here. So I'm going to have to spend extra to get those sunflowers going. Yeah, we'll do this. There. And over here. Oh. Me and the sun and I. Here. And then. I just want to get to a point. Oh, I'm nearly at that point. That's pretty good. Okay, so I need to decide now. I think what we're going to do is this guy's a little bit closer, so we'll put that there. Okay. This guy, though, is going to be a bit of a problem. There. Now I'm kind of happy, except for that top row, which is starting to develop problems. Oh goodness, look at that. Okay. Yeah. There. Much happier. Okay, all good now. Now we can just concentrate on putting down sunflowers. And then building up our defenses a little bit more. This is 3 waves, so this is going to be a little terrifying. Oh, goodness. There may be a Zomboni on all of the waves. I don't know. Huh. If there is, that would be a bit tricky. There. I hope that, yeah, that'll be fine. I was a bit worried and terrified that wouldn't work out, but it did. There we go. Awesome. And then the same for... Actually, not quite. because it turns out this guy's here. Okay. Maybe the first big wave will probably have a bucket head. And then the second and third wave might have some bonies. We'll just keep all our panic buttons open in case. I mean, it makes no sense not to do it that way, right? Right. So far, I am not seeing... Nah, I'm not seeing anything terrifying in that wave. That's fine. We'll just carry on with the plan. Oh, look at that. I say that, and then what happens is I get a swimmer. That's so mean. There we go. Yeah, you have one of those. Ooh, and a bucket head. Actually, the bucket head may be a like a legitimate problem. Spikeweed got him. Spikeweed. What am I talking about? That's not spikeweed. That's Kangle Kelp. Spikeweed is the thing we kept forgetting. Oh, I'm dead now. Oh, coin. Still poor. Alas. Okay. So now... I feel like it makes sense to do this. Realistically, I should be covering one higher. Because that covers all the rows. But the water rows... are the ones where they are most likely to send crazy things. Oh, and I hear a buckethead down there. Yeah, Mr. Buckethead, have a party. And I can now complete my plan. There we go. Plan. I'm kind of indifferent as to where to plant next. I guess we'll keep covering the water rows. Okay, so it doesn't look like there's going to be very much by way of any zombies. Maybe they'll have one in the second row. I don't know. It disturbs me that so far we haven't seen that one. Oh, oh, there. And then here. Just in case you decide you're going to break through. You know, you've got to break free. Except you don't. There we go. Okay, I like it. The buckethead is getting caught between... because he's being hit by, like, basically 8 pelts. 1, 2, 3, 4, and then double it up. Okay. Slimozo bunny? No. That's good. Oh, money, money. One of the things that kind of frustrates me about this game is, especially with the money, you have to actually be watching for it. And normally when I'm playing the game, as a result of kind of the sun mechanism, I'm almost always looking at the left-hand side. And so, like I just did there, inevitably I end up, oh, what did I do there? That was terrible. I planted the Tangle Kelp in the wrong place. Yeah. You, why don't you come up there? There. Look. Someone got him. I don't know who, but someone did. So yeah, inevitably what ends up happening is... Oh, Zomboni. I end up looking... And yes, you can also kill Zombonis with the squashes. I end up looking at the left-hand side of the screen, and as a result of doing that, I miss, like, a lot of money. Okay. I see you, Zomboni, don't worry. You can see they're part of a trail over here that the guy left behind, because I wasn't being terribly vigilant. Alrighty. And... yeah... there... to cover that. Because I saw a guy come out there, but I'm not too worried about him, because... There you go. What ends up happening with those guys is that they are very fragile. So they'll come up for 30 seconds, or not even, like, 2 or 3 seconds, and then they'll get caught. So the swimmers aren't really a big issue of mine. I suppose what I should do is cover this row. Oh, I think we're done though. It's just the last buckethead zombie. And then we're done. And that will be it for this week. Oh, this is another one of my favorite plants. Because this guy, you can do combinations of other things. They didn't do a lot of this in the first Plants vs. Zombies, which is too bad. But this is the torchwood. Peas that pass through it turn into fireballs. Well, there's an experiment I want to do with this plant, by the way. Because if peas, like from the pea shooter, that pass through it and they're regular, turn into fireballs, what happens when you do snow peas? So next week, we'll try that experiment. I don't remember how it works and what it does, but we'll see. We'll also see spikeweed, because I was terrible. I'm sorry. Thank you so much for watching. I've been Lostwolfe. This has been episode 8 of Plants vs. Zombies. Have a great week, folks, and I will see you next week. Goodbye.